2 weeks after a tanker spilled hundreds of gallons of bunker fuel into San Francisco Bay, more than a dozen of the spill's victims returned today to their normal lives. They are birds that were soaked with the oil, but rehabilitated by wildlife experts. KTVU's Christian Captain was on the Berkeley shoreline today as the birds flew free.
With a flutter of wings, 14 birds returned to the bay after spending the past 2 weeks recovering after being coated with bunker fuel.
Most of the birds we released today were American coots, 11 American coots. We did release one female surf scoter and two Dunlin.
Following the spill 2 weeks ago, 20 birds were found dead. These were among the lucky ones that were collected and have been nursed back to health. The oil coats the birds, in some cases causing chemical burns, in other cases leaving them vulnerable to the cold.
If you think of the feathers as a type of dry suit for the birds, what it does is it keeps them warm in the natural environment. And when oil gets on that dry suit, it's like us having a hole in our wet or dry suit. They get cold, they have to come out of the water. When they come out of the water, they can't eat.
The U.S. Coast Guard and the California Department of Fish and Game are running parallel investigations into the spill.
We don't rule out criminal, civil, or administrative. So those are the three areas that we have at our disposal.
Investigators say on October 30th, the crew of the Panamanian-flagged Dubai Star overfilled the ship's fuel tanks, spilling between 400 and 800 gallons of bunker fuel into the bay. Investigators are scrutinizing fuel logs and voice recorders from the ship to see how quickly crew members realized the bunker fuel was spilling and how quickly they acted to stop it.
Timeline's definitely one of the critical elements. We look at when did the incident occur, exactly what the reporting was, both on the ship and with supporting agencies.
Meantime, the cleanup was still underway today in Alameda. Crews cleaned oil-collecting booms at Otis Bridge, one of the first locations the oil started washing up. A few miles away, Robert Crown Memorial Beach was still closed. Bill Knudsen walked his dog along the shore today. He was on his honeymoon when the spill happened. When he returned, he learned that the beaches had been closed.
You have to stay on the trails away, and I generally take the dog out for walks elsewhere instead of around the beach area, so it's just kind of scary to see the oil spill signs all the way along the beach, and such a beautiful beach out here.
The seven birds that are still receiving medical care are due to be evaluated Monday and could possibly be released as early as Tuesday or Wednesday of next week. Meanwhile, no word as to when the investigation into the spill will be wrapping up. In Berkeley, Christian Kaft and KTVU Channel 2 News.